Welcome to another edition of Totally Awesome Fishing. And this time, folks, we're going to give you a part two on how to tie fishing knots. We don't want you losing any fish at all. We want it all in your favour, not in the fish's favour whatsoever. We're going to be tying fishing line to fishing hooks. As simple as that. Let's get cracking. Okay, an alternative method of joining two pieces of line together like this. Quick and easy, an overhand knot in one end of the line, keeping that knot pretty well down the end of the tag end area there. Same in the other piece of line. So joining two pieces of line, or rope it's actually used for, but I've used it fishing as well. So you've got two overhand knots, okay, in the two separate pieces of line. Now, take one end and you make another overhand knot, but you don't pull it tight. I hope you can see that one there. You put your other end of the line through that, hold it parallel like this, and you're going to go round and you're going to make an overhand knot on the other side. So you then pull this knot down tight against the shank and this knot down tight there, proverbial spin in between, and just give them a little tug to get those knots bedded a little bit. Now if you watch these two, I'll pull them very, very slowly just here. Watch them close up. There we go. And those two should roll together. I'll hold it as well. Bang. Did you see that? They absolutely roll together there. And the same principle applies. You can melt them with a knife if you want, or you can just snip those ends off there, nice and neat. It makes a little bit thicker knot than a double blood, but do you know what it's called? It's called the fisherman's knot. Now that's got to be worth using by any angler. And it's really strong. The next one is, should you have a breakage and you want to tie two pieces of line together, double blood loop. So this is one length of line, there's the other. Put a loop in one. There we go. Let's get that in the center of the lens. Put a loop in one and take the tag line through the other side. Okay, hopefully you'll be able to see this, just like that. You see it there. Now I'm going to do the standard blood loop, five turns, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I put it back through the loop. Oh, nearly lost it then. It's pretty difficult to do a 70 pound line, but at least you can see it. Start the loop, a little bit of spit as we know, push it down. So you've got one half of a blood loop there. I'm just going to tug that down a bit for you. Obviously, you use an ordinary fishing line, it's much easier. Then this other one is then sliding up and down. As you can see, it moves up and down. So now I'm going to do exactly the same with the opposite end of the line. 3, 4, 5. Tag ends here. It's going back through that loop. Through there. A little bit of spit. Tricky to do in front of the camera with thick line, but we're getting there. Pull it down. I've got it tied to a fish hook there. Get my nail on it. Give it a little tug. There we go. Pulls it down nice and tight. And they both butt up against each other. But I'm still going to give it a major bit of pulling so it goes right down on top of each other. You can feel it move this knot. Now this one leaves the tag ends sticking up perpendicular to the line. I don't really like that. So I'm going to snip them. But I'm also going to try and melt that back a bit to make a little blob on the end so they can't pull through. Okay, now what I suggest you do, if you've not done this before, just take a tag end piece of nylon, put the lighter down and just watch the end of it. Just dab it against the flame. Can you see it? There, and you can put a bit of spit on it. Like that, say burn your finger, it just leaves a little tag end there. So we're gonna give it a go. So I'm gonna snip off about that much. that much. Now, will you see this or not? I'll try and hold it to the camera so you can without setting my finger alight. Just watch that tag end. Gradually go back. Wet your finger, push it, okay? There we go. Wet your finger, dab it, otherwise it's going to stick to you. Okay, now this one is called a dropper loop. This is if you want to fish what we call a paternoster. You're dropping down to the bottom to the seabed like this. The lead is down here on the bottom and your line comes all the way up to the boat here, and you want to tie a hook in between so it stands off from the main line. So this is called a dropper loop. This end is a lead, okay? And what we're going to do is just take, say about, if you want to fish 2-3 feet off the bottom, measure it off about by your left hand, say 2 feet, and then you're going to slightly roll with your thumb a loop like this. Okay, you're going to pinch it just there, it's just a crossover loop, and you're going to roll this side here. I come around the other side, I can do it better, around several times. That's going to be a fiddle for me because I'm stretching around the camera, but hopefully this will come off. 2, 3, 4, 5. Now you put the big, basically you've got a spin up here, and a great big loop here. And the big loop you're going to put through this hole. And it's going to pull out. I'm trying to do this very, very slowly so you can see it pull tight. It's going effectively, if you can see that, look like this. Okay, so now, bit of spit either side to make it slip. Keep this loop with your thumb, and then as you pull both down towards the lead and up towards the rod line, this loop should close out like this. Now let's give it a nice pull. Now you should be able to see it. Here we go. Oh, that is sweet. Now there is a perfect dropper loop. Now, two ways of fishing a fish hook on this. Let me just undo the vise a second because I've got it tied off. It's going to be fishing like this, okay? It's going to be fishing like that, straight up and down. So your lead's going to be down the bottom. So, I just snip this off, this hook, just to give you an idea. All right, now what you've got to do is you can, if you've got a big enough eye on the hook, you just pinch the loop together, push the hook, probably through the back end. Now I go through there, not once, but I go through twice like that. Round the shank, slide it up, and look how neat that stands off there. You can see it perfect from the lead. Now, if you're going for smaller fish, and you've got smaller hooks, you can still keep this, retain the loop, still keep the loop, as you've got it there, but as you can see, the top end of the loop, turn it up the right way, the top end of the loop is there. I would snip the bottom end here, just there, okay? Then just heat the nylon up like that, and then you can tie your regular fishing knot on. I'll just do a regular little quick blood. There's not enough turns in this one, but hopefully I can get that one to go through for you, just to give you an idea. Snip off. That makes a longer one. See, it hangs down a much longer, but because I snipped the other side of the hook, the other side of the leader, you can see it makes a nice long loop. So that is a dropper loop for fishing with your lead down here on the seabed and your hook just off. And of course, you can fish two or three. You can fish another loop up here. You just roll it over like that, spin it through the gap, make about 4 or 5 turns, spin it through the gap. I'll do a real short one, this one, just to show you again. Pull the loop up. Now that's just over the length of my thumb, and you'll see it there. See, it's a short one you can tie as well. So that is the dropper loop. Okay guys, so this is a tough one. I'm gonna sit down for this one to show you. It's called a bimini loop. It's for making a long double line with a very, very strong knot strength to it.
but it's a bit of a fiddle, especially in 70 pound mono, but I'm going to try and do it. So basically, you take all your line, this is from your rod top, you've got a trace, you've got a whatever it is you want on the other end of it with your snap swivel, and you want to make a nice doubled line like this, okay, the strong. So you peel off, let's say, if you want, I'm going to tie this one short just for the sake of this. If you want, say, 8 feet, you're going to have to pull off 16 feet of line, aren't you, effectively, to make, you know, half of that a doubled line. So what you do is you want your tag end, you keep that here, and you measure off all your line. I'm not going to measure all of that off. You just toss it on the floor. Now, this is much easier to do sitting down, okay? You're sitting down like that. Now, you put 1 foot over the left-hand side and 1 foot over the right-hand side. Then you bring your knees together and you close this together as a loop. And I'll try and get this one in close-up because I want to see how you roll the knot down like this. And then I'm going to be taking a nice and tight with both the tag end here. That's this side and the real line. I'm going to put it over my knees, just over the outside of my knees, and I'm going to take a twist in it and I'm going to count 20 turns. Okay? 2, 3, 19, 20. Right, now I get that equidistant there, equal pressure there, and I'm going to pull the two top ends here apart like this, and I'm rolling that twist. If you can see that spiral down there. Now I'm going to keep my right reel line tight, and the tag end, I'm just going to kink it down, just going to run it just over so it overlaps the other knots. Now when I pull my legs apart like this, it tensions everything, and it's going to roll that entire knot all the way down in touching turns. Hopefully you can just about see that. It's a bit of a fiddle to do, but it's worth doing because it's a very, very, very strong knot. It's just a bit tough. Right, now see how that's rolled that down. It's touching there. Now, you've got to do this side first. You take a half hitch around here, put it, cinch it tight, a half hitch around there, cinch it tight. Okay, and then you close the loop. Put my foot through it again. I'll put 2 feet on this one, I think. And then you've pinched each side. So now you're going to take the tag end around the doubled main line twice. Once and twice. And just work that and pull that backwards and forwards so you get it really tight. And then just snip it off like this. Now you can mend that end with a lighter if you want, melt that end with a lighter if you want. But if not, that is a really, really good doubled knot for fishing with a double line. It's very, very strong. Okay, here's another knot for tying your fish hook on. This one's called the Palomar. You make a loop in the end of your line. You take the end of the loop and you pass it just through the eye of the hook, like that. Just like that. And then you do an overhand loop through here, taking the end of the main loop right through, leaving this quite long. It needs to be left quite long, like that, so you can see that one. And then that loop goes through the hook like this, a little bit spit because this one gets a bit of friction. And then as you pull it down, try and pull it down straight for you, you hold that loop just with your just rest it with your nail, and it'll pull down on the first knot, and then it tucks into the second knot. It's like a sort of a doubled one. There we go. Snip off the tag end. Again, being near a hook, I wouldn't bother to melt the end, and that's called the Palomar knot. Okay, the other one is for fly fishermen that want to fish a team of flies, or for sea fishermen that want to put more than one hook on the line. It's quite easy. You don't need to do it for with swivels and anything like that. You can do it straight onto the line. So your fly would be down here, or your bottom hook. The rest of the leader is all the way up here. So measure off, let's say, 15 inches for argument's sake. That's about what I'd want to fish a fly apart. And then you cut a spare piece of the same leader material, or whatever leader material you want to use. I'm using this just for just showing you. It might be just be 5 or 6 pound line. Let's say about 10 inches. So there's the end of your fly line, just there.
And there's the overlap piece. So what you're going to do is just get that tag end around about here. Pinch it together. It's dead easy, this one. Roll it over. Just making a loop like this. Just make that loop there. And then bring both the tag end, I'm going to call it, and the end of your fly leader through that loop. Let's say three or four times. Four times might be nice. Now, that was going to need wetting. I'll just put a bit of spit on there. I'll pull down. Then you pull them down. You'll see them overlap like that. And as you pull them and stretch them, bear in mind this is in 70-pound mono, so it's not easy, but at least it will show you, okay? The short piece at the front here, you just snip off. And there you have your fly on the end here. And you measure off the end of your dropper, which might be, let's say, there. You can use small hooks for sea fish, bream, gurnard, anything like that. And you can see there's no swivels on that, nothing to spook the fish. It's just a straight dropper. Okay, this is the next one we're going to be using. It's going to be tying a fly line here for trout fly fishing. A fly line and attaching your lead to it here. That's what it's going to be used for. And it's called the nail knot. I wonder why it's called the nail. Anyway, I can't try it, tie it in that 70 pound. I've already tried it, so I'm going to try and tie it for you in 30 pound high vis. So you take the end of your fly line, roughly towards the end of the nail. And I take a tag end with about 6 inches left over of my leader. I'm pinching it in there and I'm going to start wrapping it around both of those. I might have got a nail that's too big, but I'm trying to do this to show you. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so there it is. There's 6 wraps around there. Here's your line, here's the fly line, here's the leader. Now what I'm going to try and do is go in through there, the gap. You just have to sort of slacken off those coils a little bit and feed the line down through the middle by the nail. It's just coming out the other side. I envisage this one being a real pain to tie for a camera. And now I'm going to pull it, I hope you can see this, just pulling it up there, teasing it together, just slowly. Then I'm going to slide the whole rig off the nail like this. I'm still pinching those loops together and I'm just shortening them up each time, gradually cinching them down, and it's going to slide and whip down, bite into the fly line. Now don't pull it so hard that it strips the casing off the fly line. It can actually strip the casing off it. Just pull everything together, then let go of both tag ends. Just give it a tweak or two there. All you do then, you need to do is, you can snip this off really tight there, look. Snip off the tag end of your leader. Snip off the tag end of your fly line, and you have, let's move that out of the way, you have the nail knot. Okay, the next one is also for joining a fly line to a fly leader, and it's called the needle knot for reasons best known for this little chappie. Now what you do is you cut a square on the end of your fly line and you carefully work that needle point right through the fly line, I guess about an eighth of an inch. Just bend it like this so you can just bring it out. Move that fly so you can just bring that out there. Now this is a tough bit because obviously the needle gets fatter as it goes along and you don't want to push it into yourself. Okay, now I've also just squeezed flat my piece of fly leader so it's going through the eye of the needle there. And I'm going to try, he says, with a pair of pliers to pop the lot through. You can see there's a fly line. I've gone through here and I've just boarded out the side of the fly. And I'm hoping I've got enough strength to pop that right through. Come on. It's a bit of a tough one to tie this when you get it right through. Right. I'm going to come around the other side and see if I can just put the needle in the vise. Oh no, it's coming now. That's it, we got it through, okay? So now you can see the line has gone through the central core of the fly line there. Just here, gone right through it. Now we're going to tie the knot on that. There, just pull it through about 4 or 5 inches that you need, and we're going to tie the knot. Now, all you have to do is use the nail knot over the top on this section up here. So let's move everything out of the way. I'm going to try it with two nails because that gives me that groove there to slot it into. So there's my nails. I'm going to pinch it. I'm going to pull the leader through. I'm going to go around 5-6 times. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Now we're going to try it this way with two nails and see if we can get through there a little bit easier. You just got to slacken those coils off, relax them a bit to try and tease it through. That's it, it's going, and it should be out the other side, which it is. Now I'm gradually gonna, you can't see what I'm doing pretty well, but I'm trying to pull that knot down. What I'm going to do is try and take these off before I pinch them on too tight. And I'm just teasing it down underneath, keeping the coils under my finger. This is a tricky knot. I have to say I don't enjoy tying this one at all. Find them very tricky. And now, that's just about ready to pull down into the knot. Now you can't pull this one down there. Now I've just cinched it down there. If you really tear onto this tag line, it's best to pull it away. Don't do it too tight because it cuts into the plastic on the coating. So I'll just get my scissors here. I just cut off that tag line. Now when you pull it straight, as you can see there, it's a nice neat knot. It's the same nail knot, but as you can see, it's lovely, and it comes straight out the core there, comes straight out the front, and that is really a nice, neat one. Well, there you go. There's another 8 fishing knots for you to try. They cover fresh and seawater. It's up to you guys to tie the right knot. Don't lose the fish. Get out there, but more important, keep watching. Totally Awesome Fishing, how to. Until next time.